Hey guys, welcome back. Today it's a joint June sneaker release. Now what we normally do is me and Q, the bro, go back and look at the store, go forwards and look at the sneakers in June. So welcome to the page. And guys, if you don't follow me, if you don't follow Q, my name's TJ from Love Kids Customs. Go follow him. Like, follow, subscribe. And the bro to that side over there is Q.
ATL.
Go and follow the bro. And obviously, look out for the Shoe Dog podcast, because at this moment in time and airing, we will be recording the Shoe Dog podcast for Tuesday. So come and join us. Come through. We've got loads of subjects to talk about this week, because we had a guest last week, but it will be going in more depth this week, because obviously we were paying tribute to the guest last week. But June sneakers, guys. Who's looking forward to what, where, and how? Let's have a look at the releases. Let's share this, because let's get right into the nitty gritty. And first up is the Nike SB Dunk Low Phillies. What do you feel, bro?
That's fire.
anything UNC is fire, bro. Anything UNC is fire.
Anything Phillies. That Phillies. That's a legendary colorway. That powder blue with the burgundy. Like, that's a color combination that can't be beat, especially when it's got the white trim on it, like it's on that swoosh.
But what gives it that extra special spice, bro, is that gum sole. Something about gum sole, yeah? Gum sole, you see what I'm saying?
Yeah.
What do you reckon?
That's super goat right there, man.
you go with super goat. You're actually going with super goat there.
Super goat straight off top.
That's getting that super goal just because the bro wants it to give it a super goal. Definitely. Okay, next up on the release date is the new Nike SB Dunk High New York Mets. So this is obviously, we've got the Phillies, now it's the New York Mets. This is obviously the SB, and it's a high. What you reckon about this? It looks like it's got some corduroy, or the actual underlays are literally like a canvas or corduroy kind of material. Looking at it,
I don't know, man. It's a little mid-ish to me. I'd probably go 4.
I agree.
Probably go 4. Is it,
what do you prefer? SB lows or SB highs?
I really don't have a preference.
Lows
and highs. It just happens that most of the lows are better than the highs.
So. I guess by default, I
would say lows.
I think maybe skateboarding and a low is probably easier than the high. It's less restrictive on the ankle to upper ankle.
Probably. Well, maybe not. Skaters use Jordan 1 high. So
yeah, cool. True. Next up on the hit list is. The Onyx. So basically, this is just to go back quickly. The Phillies looks like they're coming out on the 2nd, on the 6th of June, and I keep forgetting to say dates. And obviously, the Mets is coming out on the 6th of June. That's basically what the calendar looks like. So the next couple of days, probably Monday onwards, we'll see more releases. By the way, we haven't covered the MMNEA 2, which is already released. We haven't covered the Green Beans, which is already released, and we haven't covered the Red Oreo, which is still sitting on the time recording this on the sneakers app. So if you want them, go and get them. Green Beans sat heavily, still probably be in your foot size. And the Amma Meunier was super limited, bro.
Yeah.
Super, super limited. I think talking to one of the bros, it looks like most of the stock was reserved for the Amma Meunier website and the Amma Meunier's foot site. So yeah, that seems like it was super limited. And unfortunately, we'll talk about this on the Shooter podcast, but unfortunately, it seems like only the US had privy to that release, because the Amma Meunier doesn't ship worldwide. So we'll talk about it in the Shoe Dog podcast, but it's another situation, reverse of what happened with Offspring to Yugo. But next up is on the 8th of June, we're getting the Yeezy Foam Runner Onyx and the Pure, the Sand, I mean, is coming back out on the 8th of June. How do you feel, bro?
I have no opinion on this shoe.
I'm gonna give it a four goats out of five, because obviously anybody that loves the Yeezy range will love foam runners. Foam runners are comfortable, as always. But next up is the Red Chillies. Has that released for you guys already?
Yeah, we got that maybe probably almost 4 weeks ago. Maybe might be 4 weeks ago today, actually.
Yeah, this is coming out on the 8th. This is coming out the 8th of June for the guys in Europe and the UK. What do you feel about that sneaker?
Four. The respectable four. Four of like a 4.7. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's very similar to the Motorboat Jones. I would have rather they re-released the Motorboat Jones, but yeah. It's not a bad sneaker at all.
I like it. It's a fire colorway, and ironically, it's sort of literally a fire colorway. I would have gone with five goats out of five, but I would go with your reflection. But that this is for me as a non nine picker up. I don't pick up Jordan nines or tens. I like to stick with other ranges, but. To me, that's a fire colorway. The execution looks like the red and the black together. You can't go wrong with that, to me personally. And a lot of people say to me, you don't like the sneaker, but you still give it that appreciation. You can not like the sneaker. You don't wear the sneaker, but you don't give it that. You give it the same appreciation like you would if you did wear it. It's because I understand like Air Max 1, I understand it. I understand the Jordan 9s. To me personally, it's because even though I don't wear it, I'm not going to say it's rubbish. That's disrespectful. So yeah. To me, I would have given that a five goats for any of the Air Jordan 9 lovers, because that is quite a really, really good colorway for a Jordan 9 come out with.
Yeah.
Next up on the hit list is the Air Jordan 3 Neapolitan Dark Mocha. But I think this is a really release for you guys, isn't it?
Yeah. When is it releasing for you?
8th of June, which is in 4 days' time of recording this.
Okay, we got that shoe on a Wednesday, the Wednesday before the Chili Red came out, I think.
Okay, so it's been like a whole month.
Yeah.
Did it sit in the US?
No, not at all. It was actually pretty hard to get. I was trying to get a pair for my niece. Me and my sister and my wife all tried, and neither one of us could get one size 8 for my niece. So
yeah. is that a US size, UK size 8-7? Yeah.
Yeah.
Say no more. I'll try for you, bro. But that was it necessary? Probably not. Is it a good colorway? I reckon it is. It's definitely for the female sneakerheads as well.
That's a men's shoe.
Hey,
that's a men's shoe.
Is it? I thought it was only female exclusive.
Well, I'm. You know what? You're right. I'm thinking about the Easter fives. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
The Regal Pink Five. That's a
mess. Exactly. I thought this was originally like a female, female size one. Yes. Yeah, so
they did extended sizes. That's what it was.
Yeah. So, but for sure, I think that's a good colorway. What do you reckon?
I give it a five, man.
Definitely. It reminds me of the Mocha Freeze as well. It's a very good iteration.
Yeah, it's pretty much a Mocha 3 with a little bit of flair on it.
Yeah, I like it. I like any 3 that comes up, to be honest. Like, it depends. A white 3 does it. To me, it brings a little bit more flair to the equation, which is nice. That I remember the laser. Was it the laser 3 where they had the yellow or the orange on it? That was quite nice. Could have been. All right, cool. Next up, that's coming out on the 8th of June. Next up on the hit list is the Nike Air Force One Mid Chocolate Cream, which is on the 9th of June. What do you feel, bro?
That looks like a very, very nice Air Force One. I don't know. I don't buy Air Force One, so I can't really judge Air Force One quality like that. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, we know Jordan quality because we touch a lot of Jordans. But I don't touch many Air Force Ones, if any at all. So it looks real nice. It looks premium. Look like that suede is real buttery.
Oh yeah, it's almost giving me those British khaki vibes, but like a shorter, a mid. You know, British khakis more like proper hairy. This is like semi hairy, like a mid hair.
It reminds me like the hair on the Raging Bull or the hair on the Alternate Great Five, something like that.
Yeah, I'm gonna give this. If you don't, I don't know if you agree with me, but I'm gonna give this a 4 go.
Yeah, for sure. I agree with that.
Just suggest out of respect. Because we're not Air Force wearers, to be honest. Like, we more Jordans. But next up on the hit list, by the way, that comes out on the 9th of June. Next up on the hit list is something you're not going to get, but we're going to get. I don't understand. And to be honest, let me check on the sneakers app, because they don't call it the Zen Masters on the sneakers app. It's something else. But what do you feel better?
Amethyst Mist.
Yeah, it's cool. It's I can't even say it, bro. Say that again.
Amethyst
Mist. Yeah, that's the one. But its nickname is Zen Master. It pays tribute to the Chicago Bulls coach Phil Jackson. Apparently, but if it did, it should have come out in the States. But it's not. So apparently, it's not coming out in the States. But what do you feel about them, bro? Because I do like them, but I don't think it's for me.
No, I'm still on the fence on whether I even like it or not. It looks like it's ripstop or like mesh, Cordova mesh or something like that. And that color with that graphic, I ain't, with the black, it don't go.
I'm gonna say one thing, right? The pictures from the sneakers for the official pictures look, or the stock pictures look good, right? I don't like that.
Yeah,
that looks horrible.
I'm good on those. That's a no go for. That's a no go for me. That's gonna be like a 3 for me. it's a 3 because it's a 4. No pun intended. You know what I'm saying? It's like I can't go lower than a 3 just because it's a Jordan 4. You know what I mean?
Yeah. I get that. I don't understand the sneaker. The history behind it sounds like it's a tribute to Phil Jackson. The colorway, the official name for the colorway is coming out, is different to the Zen Master. It was called the Zen Master last year. And the sneaker doesn't make sense. It doesn't make sense at all. Maybe
it's a different color. Like, I don't know why they went with that amethyst. I mean, I get it. Zen, we know Phil Jackson's supposed to be into the whole Zen thing or whatever, but.
I ain't asked
for that.
Next up, bro, it's a big hit. That, by the way, the Zen Master is coming out on all the Amethyst Mid Wave is coming out on the, I'm just double checking it, on the 9th, which is correct, 9th of June. Next up is something that's come out of nowhere. It probably will be the heat for the month, and it just came out of nowhere because nobody saw this coming. Bang. The Tom Sachs Nightcraft General Purpose Shoe.
Yeah.
It literally came out of the blue, bro. Nothing. Like, just read the description below. General Purpose Shoe is where to buy. Basically, just gives you where to buy. You've got no history behind it. I need to learn more bit about it, but this is the same person that created the Mars Sachs. It looks average, but there's going to be some meaning behind it, for sure.
That shoe is dope.
I think it's dope. I do think it's dope. But on visuals, it just looks like, you know what it reminds me of? 980.
It's a super old school look to it.
Yeah.
You know, got the vintage color, you know, with the sale on there. They threw the gum on the midsole, which I don't think I've ever seen a gum midsole.
Nah, we've seen the gum sole, outsole, but we haven't seen the gum midsole.
You've never seen a gum midsole. I mean, it might not be gum. It might just be paint, right? But
I might be wrong. Doesn't it look like a semi mashup between like a waffle and a Cortez?
Yeah, something like that, yeah. It's a hybrid. It's definitely a hybrid. I'm giving it a four. I respect it.
Yeah, it looks like it's got like a waffle sole to it, outsole to it as well.
Probably so. I respect it.
I'm gonna get. We agree with it. That might change after we learn more about it.
that's a hype move right there.
Yeah,
that's a hype move. I like the shoe, but it will be a hype move for me to wear it. I can admit that 100%. That would truly be a hype move. That's like what we were saying before when you respect the shoe, but it's not for you. I could make that for me, for hype purposes.
I'm gonna say this. This is the epitome of dad shoes. This is like, you know, back in the day, you used to cut your grass in sneakers like that, or a variation of sneakers like that. Like, this is how far the trend's gone with dad sneakers. It's like almost like this is the pinnacle. It reminds. So this is something your father would wear. Like, you know, like a.
That's hard, bro. I'm
sure
enough with that,
bro. Uncle Q rocking the Tom Sachs Nightcraft general purpose.
Yeah, if I have a chance to get my hands on them, I'm gonna do that. I just sat here and talked myself into it.
10th of June. The ratings might change. I want to know more about that sneaker. Next up on the hit list is the Nike Air Max 97 Fred. And you are laughing, bro, because you said something to me before we start recording. What was that, bro?
That is the Nike Air Max 97, not Nas X.
All that's missing, like you said, was that red. Yeah, red air bubble inside.
Red on that shoe. That Nike should have just made the air bubble red. I mean, it's a black Nike. Where's the red? They calling it bread, but it's just a red swoosh. That's not a bread. It ain't enough red on there to call that bread.
Yeah, I would have liked. See where the 97 just, you got the lining for the 97. That if that was all red, that would have been dope. I think that would have been dope.
You can do it on Nike ID. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah, pretty much. But that would have been dope. Like, in between black and red going up. That, what are you gonna give that? The non-X Nas X.
I'm gonna give Nike a 3 just for saying, you know what? We're gonna put out our version.
This is how it should be.
We just missed this guy already. Let's just go ahead and put one out. It should have made that bubble red though.
Yeah, that is more red, would have been a bit more of a take on the bread, but like it is all black, but like little bit hints of like in there, just the sole there and just a tick there. It's not enough red for me, to be honest, to be called a bread. We could have called it bullet black, maybe. You never know. Next up, that's coming out on the 10th of June. Next up is the Air Jordan 1. High vaults, but I'm going to call them the Kick Lord 2s.
The Kick Lord 2s is what we're calling this. this is the Jordan 1
Kick Lord 2.0. Let's make that thing. If you follow us on Instagram, you know exactly what we're talking about, because Kick Lord's a bro, and we always joke around because he rocked the vaults, the first variation of the vaults, to death. Like, I'm talking every day of the week he was wearing the votes. Now we're going to call this the Air Jordan 1 Kick Claws 2.0. Mm-hmm. But I think they're nice. I think they're nice. There's Chicago color blocking on that.
Yeah, that's enough said. It's hard.
What are you giving it, bro?
I'm going to give it a 5.
Just for the bro.
I'm going to give it a 5. Especially if the material is nice. It might be a super goat, because that shoe will live in infamy. I guarantee you.
Really?
Jordan 1s have died down, and prices aren't what they used to be as far as aftermarket is concerned. But trust me, people are going to love this shoe. I bet.
Oh, look at the materials on that, bro. And if you're interested in that shoe, that's the 11th of June that's coming out. Look at the materials on that, bro. Like, look at the actual panel on that. That is buttery. Looks buttery. But yeah, very vaulty, bro. Very vaulty. We're very green vault.
I like it.
Highlight a green vault. I'm interested to see it's got this. Hey?
It's gonna be nice and looking in the dark too.
By the way, this looks like the tongue is aged out as well. Yeah, aged or stale. That the vaults or the Kick Lord 2.0s are coming out on the 11th of June. Next up is 13th of June. We got the Air Max 95 Lemon Lime.
They should have made them blue.
You reckon?
Yeah. Blue with the green and yellow, like a Sprite can.
Oh, bro! Like I might need to do some photoshopping after this.
these nice though.
I like them. It's very summery, very very summery, bro. Like you need to rock these in the summer when it's hot. Just it's bouncing super your
life. Like that's daytime casual action all day, all summer long.
I'm going to say 4 goats.
I'm going to say 5.
The bro is going in. He's giving so many fives this year, this month.
Bro, hey, man.
There is so much heat. There's so much heat. There's so much heat this year. There's so much heat this month, I mean. Next up, by the way, that lemon lime is coming out on the 13th of June. Next up, and there's more pictures of that. Bro, that's dope. It's dope, though. I love the orange air unit on that. It's so nice. Next up is this is coming out. I think the 14th, but this is the Jordan. Let me just check the dates. This is coming out on the 14th. This is the Biohack Low Fly Yeezy for all the people that can't get into their sneakers. For disabled people that can't get into the sneakers, it literally is a sneaker that opens up slots in. You don't even need to lace them up or nothing like that. Very very nice. I love the Biohack. Myself personally, that low variation looks dope for anybody that's disabled. I think you need to promote this for people that can't, or disabled people that can't wear sneakers or tie up the laces, need to get that first before anybody else. That's dope. I like that.
We already know people gonna buy this shoe up just because it's a Biohack colorway, and a lot of people that really need it ain't gonna be able to get their hands on it for retail, which is unfortunate. But
guys,
if y'all know us, y'all know how we feel about stuff like this. I mean, even if it's something I wanted to get my hands on.
Super dope.
Shout out to Nike and Jordan Brand for even saying, let's go ahead and give this silhouette something that's going to take it to a different level.
Yeah,
and doing that Biohack on the fly, even though I don't like Biohacks, you gotta respect that, man. I know what Biohacks mean to the community. So,
that was my sneaker of the year a couple of years back. The Biohacks, but the low fly easy range needs to go, just like the Dawn Makers. All the money needs to go to charity. The Fly Yeezys need to go to the people that can't wear their sneakers. Because imagine if you liked a pair of sneakers, you couldn't get your feet into a pair of sneakers. That's the way that Jordan Brand accommodate them. So please, please, guys, I do applaud you to let the people that want to get that, they can't fit their sneakers they can't fit their sneakers on properly without tying them. Let them get the Fly Yeezys, please. And that's out of respect for people that want to wear sneakers that can't actually wear sneakers and can't put the sneakers on without tying laces and stuff.
There's also, I'm looking at Jordan 1 Low Fly Ease Reverse Black Toe that's coming out on June the 16th. So I also saw another one.
There's a couple.
I can't remember what the other colorway was that I saw, or the other silhouette. But they're doing a lot. It's going to be a lot of Fly Ease releases coming. But this Biohack, that we it's already good. Know what's going to happen with that. You know, resellers going to buy that shit.
Not good.
If they know about it.
By the way, we're going to see some dope thing now. But this is the Biohack Fly Ease lows are on the 14th of June. Bro, you ready for this one, right? Because goddamn.
Yo, that is a super goat. I'm just gonna say that. I'm gonna also say I wish my foot was a little smaller. It's a women dude.
It is the season for the eights, bro. It is a season for the eights.
It's a women's release. So if they do not extend sizes on this shoe, it will be a half size too small for me. And if y'all eights already run tight, so you have to do at least your full size.
I'm going to get a 9.5 and I'm going to put a foot tread in it to expand it because, bro, dope. That is dope. That's the one of the sneakers I'll be banging to get. You know what? That sneaker's gonna sit,
bro.
In the UK.
I mean, that's hard, bro. I can't really tell if it's leather or if it's
leather.
Neoprene or.
It looks like it's leather.
It looks so glossy. Like, it's so shiny. It's blinded me.
That is... You magpie. Yo, bro. 100%. Ooh. Dope sneaker. Dope.
That's the 1.8. That's the 1.8 other than the Rui 8 that I've seen since the Tinker 8s that I really, really want.
Yeah,
we really, really want because then we know we might see 1.8 a year.
Yeah,
if this is the one outside of the Rui, I mean, I don't count the Rui because it's a collab, however, yeah. Yeah, that's I don't even want to talk about that. I just want to,
yeah, Let's just hope there's loads of pairs of these, and let's just hope that you're able to cut one for yourself because
they extend the size.
That is a dope colorway, bro. Dope colorway. The yellow is popping. By the way, if you want to see this, let me just extend this and show you guys. Look at Dust of Soul. It's on the sneakers app, but that's the medial. That is dope. That is so dope. Top view. Dope. Back view. Booty action there. Dope sneaker. I'm excited for that one. I'm 100% excited for that one. Oh. Let me just get this right. 100% excited for that one. So, next up on the hit list, that was our super goat. There's the third super goat for this month. On our hit list again, and that's on the 16th of June if you guys want it. On the hit list again is on the 16th. Of June, we should be getting the Air Max 1 Light Matter Root. That's already been released on a shop drop from Alive, but Nike's getting official release on the 16th of June. So if anybody missed out on the Light Matter Roots, dope colorway, dope execution, dope sneaker. If you want it, it's going to come out on the 16th of June, and I'm going to give it a 5 goats, I reckon. Dope colorway.
You can't give it less than 5. The materials, colorway, also the tree line.
What you don't see on this is the air bubble unit inside is the same color as the tick.
Right.
You can't see it, but like you can slightly see it, but you can't see it. But when you get it in hand, it's dope. Dope sneaker. Absolutely dope sneaker. Air Max 1. This Air Max 1, definitely a thing, bro. Definitely a thing. Like I will talk about it in the Shudo podcast, but definitely a thing. I want to mention. I can tell there's a massive push for these, and we'll talk about it. Next up, on the 16th of June, you're also getting the Jordan 6 Midnight Navies.
Yeah, we already got that in the US.
You already picked up your pair, bro.
Yeah.
What do you reckon? In hand, would you reckon?
Hey. Sleep on them if you want to. That's all I'm gonna say. Okay. You know what? I got the perfect analogy for that shoe. People love the Maroon 6, right?
Yeah.
Jordan brand says you're welcome.
I slept on the Oreo 6, red Oreo 6, because I don't. I got a Carmine, Carmine 6s. I'm not gonna miss out on this one for sure.
The leather on that loves your hands. it loves your fingers.
I can't wait. I can't wait for that. I definitely can't wait for that. Next up on a hit list is something that is the bro E got souls from Instagram once. 16th of June. It is the Air Jordan 1 Low Mystic Navy.
Yeah. It's OG-ish. It's not all the way OG.
Yeah.
But it's very, very OG-ish. But I don't like that blue versus the royal. I mean, it's not a bad. It's like a low marina blue.
Yeah.
But it's Mystic Navy. Like all these different color blues. Like, just give us royal.
Yeah.
But exactly. It's a Jordan 1 Low OG, so yeah, it's kind of a 5 anyway.
I'm gonna give it a 4 goats. Yeah.
Go.
Four goats. That's a good colorway. It's a good goal. It's good, definitely good colorway. I'm going in for E, definitely for sure on that one. He's been asking for that for the last month or so. Next up, Yeezy 700 high res.
Yeah.
This is hard for me personally. It's pushing it too far. You're looking at me with that look, bro. It's pushing it too far, bro. What do you mean it's hard?
I don't know.
It's hard to get over the fact that it's all too red.
I like it.
Do you like it? Okay, cool. I'll give it your rating if you pick it up for yourself.
I'm probably not going to try to get it. But I give it a 5.
Are you going to give it a 5?
Yeah.
And I'm the 700 lover, and I actually want to give it a 3.
Look, the 700 is my favorite Yeezy silhouette, if you can call it that. But I don't buy or wear Yeezys. if I did, I would really need this one. Ooh. If I bought Yeezys, if I had Yeezys in my collection, I would really need this one. That's just my so because I'm not a Yeezy guy, let's go with your rating. Because I don't feel like my rating really counts.
I don't like the fact that this got a white toe to it.
I like that. It just looks odd.
It looks odd to me, bro. All right, cool. We make a compromise.
That profile shot, that side shot, it looks better. The white part looks better to me. But the toe down, I don't really like
it. I'm gonna go compromise and give it a four goats out of 5. Just because you like it, bro. Hey, I'm going for your size, bro. You better pay me.
We wear the same size. What are you talking about? You going for my size? You going for your size?
All right. Next up, the 17th is going to get crazy
on the 17th for those. Watch.
Reckon?
Mm-hmm.
I will try and go through our size, and if you want it, I'll give it to you. Next up is one day you will have a wave run on your feet, bro. Next up is the Air Jordan 1 Low, which I thought was going to come out last month, but it's not. It's the bleached coral, nice, dope, cracked. It looks like it's got cracked leather. The soft pink new suede on that, it looks gorgeous, bro. Looks gorgeous.
Yeah, that's a ridiculous looking shoe right there. I mean,
look at the quality on that, bro.
Like that Mystic Blue ain't this. This right here. And I ain't a pink guy, but that's hard.
That's super good, bro. That's definitely a super good.
That's hard.
OG, you know. I'm talking like the OG cut, OG
stitching. The black toe treatment, the OG swoosh. That's what I meant when I was, the swoosh on that.
Yeah.
It's not the same style swoosh that's on that Mystic Blue. That Mystic Blue swoosh looks more like an up-to-date retro one swoosh. This one.
Yeah, when we're talking about OG, we're talking about OG cut, OG tick, OG stitching at the back with Air Jordan at the top rather than the bottom. It's definitely a dope color. You know what? I hope I'm able to cop this for he's been asking about this for months. But 17th of June, guys. 17th of June, if you're looking out for that bleached color.
Gonna be hot on the 17th.
Well, yeah, you're right, mate. Next up is another Nike Dunk Low, but it's the Valerian Blue. Like it. I like it a lot.
Yeah. I get a 4.
Okay. I agree with you with that. I like it a lot.
I do like it.
Four goats out of 5, bro. Four goals out of five. Next up, we're going to pick up the pace a bit because obviously we're verging on nearly more than half of 30 minutes. But next up is the Air Jordan 3 Dark Iris, which is coming out on the 18th of June. Apparently, I like it a lot. I like it a lot.
I don't know about the dates. By the way, everybody, we know. If y'all into sneakers, y'all know these dates we calling out subject to change because we reading them just like they posted. Yeah. So I like this one. It does remind me of the Racer Blue.
Yeah.
I have to see it in hand. That purple.
I'm gonna say one thing that Jordan Jumpman looks suspect, bro. He looks like he's been on a three course meal for quite a while.
Yeah.
I like the mock up. I love it. I think it's a great colorway.
I think that purple a little dim.
Yeah.
I think it could be more vibrant, but. Cool.
But we don't know where this sneaker come from, so basically could be a UA, I don't know. But this is the mock-up. If it looks like the mock-up, it's going to be decent. I think it's four goats out of five is a correct subject. Nice colorway. Purple being the push from Jordan for the next couple of years. I said that a couple of, a year ago. I think the purple was the next big push. Next up. Is the Yeezy Boost 350 V2 Bone and then the Onyx as well. But I don't see the point for the Onyx because we already got like loads and loads of black variations of the 350. This 350 V2 has got the transparent stripe that runs through it, like the bone, transparent that you can see the inside. But for me personally, summer shoes, great summer shoes, especially the white, all white version. It's whatever it is, really, to be honest. Another 350, another variation, another sneaker that is be easily accessible to everybody. Another four goats for all the Yeezy fans that want it. For sure. It's nice to see 350s keep releasing for people that really want them. If you want them, definitely worth it. Next up is the New Balance made in US Marblehead pack. So this is the variation 2, this is the variation 3, and this is the variation 1. So they've done a three variation tier of the Marblehead made in USA New Balance 990.
That's a 555 right there.
555. Yeah. Agree with you, bro. 555 on the New Balance front. Very good colorway. I think a lot of people will be going for them.
The materials on those look outstanding.
Premium, yeah. But when is New Balance not come with premium materials? That's the thing. The price, you pay the price as well. 22nd of June if you want it, guys.
Mm-hmm.
Next up is, this is one of the ones that's going to divide everybody, is the Off-White Nike Air Force 1 Mid White.
It just looked crazy, man.
Isn't it a track? It looks like a track. It almost looks like a track shoe, doesn't it?
I don't know what it looked like, bro. Like, that is crazy. That is really, really crazy. Like, you could tell Virgil was a high fashion guy.
Yeah.
You could really, really tell with this one. Like, we thought the running shoes he did were crazy. Now, this is extreme. Like, this is beyond anything that you would expect to see on a shoe associated with Nike. Like, this is... I can't do it, bro.
Would you rate it, in your opinion? Just off this. Let me just go just off that. What would you rate it? By the way, this looks like it's a replica. That looks like it's from a replica company. So let's go back to this. Would you reckon?
I can't even rate it, bro. I mean, if I have to give it anything, it'll be a one. I mean, I can't give it a zero, so it's gonna have to be a one.
I'm gonna give it a two guns. I'm gonna give it two guns.
One for me, and one for you.
Yeah,
bro, tell me what's good about it.
I said another unique design from Virgil. God rest his soul. But next up is another 350, the V2 Bluetooth. It's I think it's a re-retro of Could be a re-retro of an old silhouette. I know they did a blue tint, blue version tint on this, but yeah, looks dope. Looks definitely nice. And it's in the vein of the zebra. So on that note, I'm gonna give it a four goats. Definitely a sneaker. I think a lot of people will be going for if you're a 350 fan. Next up on the hit list is. It is the infrared 4.
Do I have the 24th
of June.
Do I have to tell you how I feel about this shoe? Do I really have to tell you how I feel about this?
No, you don't, bro. That is an instant super goal.
Yeah, and you know what? That rating probably won't hold. But right now, yeah, that's him. This is what we asked for.
I think I'm with arm chasing the military blacks at this moment in time. I can sacrifice those for these.
Yes.
These are better than the military blacks.
We are supposed to be getting those on the 15th.
Okay. We're getting these on the 24th of June. In Europe and UK, we're getting them on the 24th of June. Definitely a dope sneaker. I would say if you like the cool gray force, if you like the green gloves, this is your sneaker.
This for me is a no-brainer. Even with the white, as much white, I do wish the midsole had the outsole had a little bit more going on, but I don't care.
I like it a lot. Definitely a lot. I would probably be going for these even more than the billion military blacks, if I'm honest. And like, to be honest, I just lost a bit more. I didn't pick them up. If it's meant to be, it will be as for the military blacks, but I'm going in hard for these infrared force. Definitely, bro. 100%. Oh, to my personal opinion, a way better sneaker than the military blacks.
Yeah, for sure. For sure. We asked for those, but
not better than the military blues. That's OG. All right, next up on the hit list, if you want the infrareds, like I said, 24th of June. What date was it? 15th?
15th for you guys? For the US.
For US, North America. And next up is the Air Jordan 3 Desert Elephant. What do you think, bro?
They're cool.
I'm gonna say this was the mock-up from Z Sneakers. Shout out to Z Sneakers. I did not like this variation because it was too close to the cement. Would you call it black cement?
Black cement threes. Yeah.
Yep. But I like this.
Yeah, I mean, it's got the OG cut. That brown, orangish looking color is nice. It's nice. Just a nice looking shoe, man. Suede, leather.
You just gray. Want me to give it. You just want to give it a four goals, yeah.
I'm leaning close to five. I mean, it's nice. It might not be for me.
Yeah.
But it's hard. Yep. I like that. I like that a lot more than the mock-up.
First time in ages, the mock-up. It beats the mock-up.
Yeah. I think it beat the mock-up, yeah.
Next, bro. Is the Union LA Nike Cortez khaki red? How you feeling?
There's one thing about this shoe that I don't like, which is that back tab.
Well, this back tab, the Union back tab there.
Yeah, I don't like how it's not fully attached.
Uh-huh.
But it's hard. I like this.
Oh, yeah. Oh, you got Nike underneath it. You can actually, stop. I like that. I'm gonna for the time being without actually seeing it in hand, I'm gonna give it five goats. It's definitely a dope sneaker. By the way, there's a women's pair. I think that might be the women's exclusive pair. There's a men's pair. There's also another. There's like four or five variations of that sneaker. The Cortez. There's a massive big push for the Cortez. In terms of Union.
I like most of them. Hopefully, people that wear Cortez, or as we call them in the South, or in America in general, dope mans.
Yeah.
Hopefully, people that like dope mans can get their hands on these too.
Okay. I don't. This is on the list, but I don't know if it. I think it's already released in the UK. But this is the Blank Canvas Fours. We had a semi drop on the sneakers up, I think.
I ain't heard nothing about this shoe. I've seen, media about it, obviously, but I have not seen or heard about a release date at all.
Actually, it wasn't the sneakers app. It was sneakers and stuff. That actually raffled in sneakers and stuff, and there was nothing there. But to be confirmed, date is the 30th of June at the moment, so it could be the end of the month when we see this. Let's see what happens with it.
Yeah. I like it.
What do you think? You like it?
Yeah, I give it a five.
Okay. That's a high range. I was gonna say four, but then you could make it into a five or a super goat yourself.
Yeah, that's why I give it a five, just for
customization ability of it.
Yeah, because kids gonna go crazy with these. Some people gonna rock them straight up, which is fine. Also, they look fine the way they are. Mm-hmm. That canvas material, the canvas wing. I think the back tab is canvas too.
Just go through this quickly. Yep, that's canvas too.
Yeah.
It almost reminds me of the Levi Force.
Right.
The white Levi Force.
Right. I'm digging those.
Next up, last but not least, we're going to leave it on a sour note because I know you're not feeling these. And check out the Shoe Dog podcast, guys, because we'll be talking about Yeezy. We're talking about Kanye. We're talking about his big push into the NBA because obviously it looks like he's got a big piece. He looks like he's getting serious about the NBA. Join us in the Shoe Dog podcast on Tuesday when we'll be talking about this. But this is the Yeezy basketball knit slate Azure, which basically is scheduled sometime in June. Sometime in June, bro.
Trash.
on that note, I'm gonna give it a three out of five at the moment. I'm pretty sure the ratings will drop after that anyway because I don't really I'm not keen with it. It looks
that shoe's gonna fit, bro.
Yeah, I think it will. I think you might be right. But that was a release for that's not all the release.
I got a couple.
Actually, yes, you're right. We didn't discuss the Air Max 1.
the Casino pack.
Yep.
I apologize for the pictures. I couldn't really find better pictures on short notice, but these release on the 8th. I'm not sure if that's the worldwide release, but US
Let me just double check on the sneakers app as we speak, because basically it should be on there if it's going to release on the 8th for us, and it doesn't look like it's on here, so it could be the US only at the moment.
So this goes.
So I've seen the pack. I apologize for mentioning this, but yeah, that's getting a dope. That's getting a super dope, bro. That is a dope pack.
That's right.
And bro, there's a reason why I wanted to talk about Air Maxes to on the Pseudo podcast, and I will discuss it after this recording. But yeah, next up, bro. What's up next?
We have the Jordan 1 Bleach Coral. I don't know who asked for this. Hopefully whoever is asking for this can get it. This shoe will be heavily customized, I believe, just because of the black toe and the gray.
It's
going to be easy access for customizers. It's okay. I mean, hopefully the materials don't on it, but I'm cool on these. I give them a 4.
4 goats?
Yeah, I give them a 4. A low 4.
A low 4. Virgin on 3. Are you saying it's a 3.5 out of 4, yeah?
I give it a 4. Straight up. Okay. I give it a flat 4. And last, but certainly not least, what you think about these, man? I know you don't like nines.
I think they're sold up. Remember the all black nines that released years and years ago, that which basically everybody got.
Mm-hmm.
Was it a bread nine? It was just all like the 97. Yeah, pattern level, all black with a red, with touches of red on it. That kind of put me off nines, if I'm honest as well. But even though it was dope, but that put me off nines. I think that's a dope. I like the grey touches to that, the black touches to that, and the white sole outsole to that. It's dope, very dope sneaker.
Yeah, red on the back of the.
Yeah, definitely. What are you giving it?
I'm giving that a 5.
Yeah, I agree with you on that one, bro.
And they decided to go with mesh again on the overlay on this 9, like they did on the Chili Red. It's like the same material, that like canvas mesh type of material.
Uh-huh.
So yeah, I'm liking those. Look like gray Nubuck.
Yeah.
OG box. All that. Yeah, man. That's it.
That was really so. On that note, what are you looking forward to the most next month?
Them 8s, the infrared 4s,
midnight navies.
I already got those.
I'm looking forward to those.
Yeah, you should. And I'm gonna try to see what's up with them Tom Sacks.
Yeah. I'm Zen Masters. I'm not, or the Amnesis Wave. I'm not looking forward to the Vault ones. I'll probably try and get for Kick Lord if he's still around. If you want some, the eights are taxi eights. So dope. I'm also the Air Max ones. The Air Max ones are dope. They're the ones you showed.
The casinos,
they're definitely a dope sneaker. But other than that, I'm just going for the taxis, the midnight navies, and what's the other one? And
700s.
Not 700s. What are we talking about, bro? What's the other one that we just talked about? The midnight navies, the taxis, infrared fours. That's the one, bro. That's the one. That's the 3 on the hit list for this month. That's the only 3 I'm wearing for this month. But What are you guys looking forward to? What are you, leave it in the comments, what are you guys looking forward to? What you are actually basically vying for? The ratings that we give are our personal ratings, are what we feel about the sneaker without looking at them in hand, just visual aspects. Your ratings might change because everybody has different tastes in sneakers, but that's pretty much it for me and Q. So, on that note, guys, hope you enjoy all the sneakers for June. Hope you go and pick up the sneakers you want in June. And if you can't, just keep hunting, because there are always going to be pairs out there that are out in the wild that need to be hunted down. So on that note, from me and from Q, and guys, join us on the Shootout podcast on Tuesday, because we'll be talking further onto the releases and all the different subject matters. But as I normally say, I hope you have an amazing week, amazing month, and an amazing year. And I hope you guys cop all the June sneakers you want, because you all deserve to get all the June sneakers you need. So from me and from Q, peace out, guys. Peace.